Rifles have long been the cornerstone of military power, providing soldiers with the firepower needed to dominate the battlefield. Over the course of history, rifles have evolved to meet the ever-changing demands of warfare. As warfare becomes more complex, so too does the technology needed to give soldiers an edge. The rifle, once a simple instrument of survival, has transformed into a highly specialized weapon designed to deliver greater accuracy, firepower, and reliability in the heat of battle. From the days of the Revolutionary War to modern conflicts, the US military has built a proud tradition around its rifles, constantly evolving to meet the demands of new warfare. Over the years, American soldiers have been equipped with a variety of iconic rifles, some of which have earned legendary status, forever etched into military history. From the M1 Garand of World War II to the M16, these weapons have become symbols of American strength and ingenuity. Now, with the development and testing of a new generation of firearms, one can't help but wonder, will this latest rifle join the ranks of these battlefield legends? As troops put it through its paces, only time will tell if it will carry forward the legacy of its predecessors and become another storied weapon in the hands of the US military. Some weapons age like fine wine. The M4 is unquestionably one of these weapons. This gun had its ups and downs, but it managed to prevail and earn the respect of both friends and foes. The M4 was officially accepted into service by the United States military in 1994, and it first saw action in the hands of US troops deployed in Kosovo in 1999. It was later heavily used by US forces during the global war on terror, including Operation Enduring Freedom and Operation Iraqi Freedom. By 2005, the M4 had largely replaced the M16A2s as the primary weapon of forward deployed personnel in the United States Army. In addition, the M4 carbine replaced most submachine guns and selected handguns in US military service. The story of the M4 carbine goes back to the mid-60s and the early days of the Vietnam War. The original prototype version of this gun was made by Colt just 2 years after the creation of the M16 in 1966. The prototype was called the XM177, aka Colt Commando. Special Forces teams wanted something more compact, so Colt engineer Rob Roy designed the XM117 to use a 10-inch barrel, which is half the size of the 20-inch M16A1 barrel. But then he had to put a flash suppressor, making the overall barrel length 14.5 inches. Roy also gave the gun a beautiful telescoping tubular aluminum buttstock so the user could adjust the length of the rifle to some extent. The new buttstock was loved, but shortening the M16 wasn't as simple as just swapping out a shorter barrel, since the short barrel meant that the gas port had to be shortened and moved down as well. The M4 is cycled by the gas impingement system, and messing with the length of the tube that sends the gas through the gun also messed with the performance. To counter this issue, the weapon's pressure was increased from the M16's 10,000 psi to 17,000 psi. A change which caused malfunctions. Initial combat experiences in Afghanistan and Iraq resulted in several desired updates, addressing the reliability and durability of the carbine. As a result, the M4A1 carbine and the M4 carbine were fitted with a heavier barrel, which better withstands protracted and intense firing. By 2015, the M4 or M4A1 carbine became the primary fighting rifle for the US Army and US Marine Corps infantry units. Chambered for the standard NATO 5.56x45mm ammunition, M4's internal design has 80% parts commonality with M16A2. M4 has an effective range of 1,182 feet. It weighs 7.75 pounds with 30 rounds and a sling. This carbine is fed from the standard M16 magazines, holding 30 rounds. It is compatible with the earlier 20-round magazines of the original M16 and other standard Stanag magazines. The safety or fire mode selector switch is located above the pistol grip on the left side of the receiver. The trigger mechanism has semi-auto and 3-round burst modes. When the gun is fired, the cocking handle located at the rear of the receiver does not reciprocate. Ejection port is located on the right side. It has a deflector which propels spent cases away from left-handed shooters. Except for the first production run, almost all M4 carbines have flat-top receivers with integrated Picatinny rails which replace the M16A2 style carrying handle. Most current production M4 carbines also feature RIS forends with additional rails. Compared to the M4, the M4A1 has full auto capability, a consistent trigger pull, and a slightly heavier barrel. The heavier barrel is more durable and has greater capacity to maintain accuracy and zero while withstanding the heat produced by high volumes of fire. In 1994, US Special Operations Command, or USSOCOM, and the Navy developed the Special Operations Peculiar, or SOPMOD, M4A1 accessory kit to make this weapon exceptional in versatility, lethality, and effectiveness. However, 30 years on the front lines is a long time, and the future of combat necessitates the development of new weapons and doctrines. The stopping power of the current assault rifles became a concern as body armor technology became more widely available to military forces around the world. As Russia and China plan to equip their troops with highly efficient and functional body armor, the American monopoly on this issue will inevitably end. And no US soldier wants to be the guy who brought a pea shooter to a real gunfight. Don't get us wrong. The M4 has been a remarkable alternative to the M16 rifle and has performed quite well. But the times, they are a-changing. So should the calibers. Enter the SIG SPEAR XM7, a new battle rifle designed to replace the M4 as the standard issue firearm for the United States Army and the new cartridge that goes with it. The XM7, originally known as the XM5, is the US Army's adaptation of the SIG MCX Spear, a 6.8x51mm gas-operated rifle. This rifle, crafted by SIG Sawyer, was developed under the 2022 Next Generation Squad Weapon Program. The Next Generation Squad Weapon Rifle, or NGSWR program, is an ambitious military project led by the US with the goal of developing a new standard-issue rifle principally for the US Army and possibly for other branches of the military. Initiated in the late 2010s, the NGSWR program has set its sights on supplementing the existing M4 carbine and M16 rifle platforms, which are the current mainstays of American soldiers. The 6.8x51mm common cartridge, also known as the 6.8mm Next Generation Squad Weapon Cartridge, is a recently developed intermediate cartridge, custom made by SIG Sawyer for the US military. The design of this cartridge aims to overcome the perceived limitations of the long-standing 5.56x45mm NATO and 7.62x51mm NATO rounds, which have been in service for several years. The chief objective of the 6.8x51mm cartridge is to bring about substantial improvements in range, precision, and terminal ballistics compared to existing ammunition. Its design is intended to provide superior performance in a variety of combat scenarios, including long-range engagements and the capability to penetrate barriers such as body armor. The 6.8 by 51 mm cartridge is a powerful and formidable round engineered to deliver exceptional performance by maintaining a flatter trajectory and transferring greater energy to its target, particularly over extended distances. The Army's specific ballistic requirements for this cartridge necessitate an astonishing chamber pressure of 80,000 psi. To put this into perspective, the commonly used 5.56 NATO round generates approximately 60,000 psi, while the 7.62 NATO round produces around 62,000 psi. In comparison to these military calibers, the 6.8 by 51 mm cartridge generates an unparalleled level of pressure, making it significantly more potent in terms of ballistic force. The XM7 NGSWR battle rifle comes with a variety of features that make it a versatile and effective weapon. It includes a fully adjustable and collapsible stock, charging handles at the rear and side, an M-lock handguard that is free-floating and reinforced, fully ambidextrous controls, and a detachable suppressor. The rifle utilizes a magazine-fed system and operates from a closed bolt position. Its short stock piston mechanism guarantees optimal performance even in challenging conditions, and the design ensures the weapon can function with or without a suppressor attached. The XM7 NGSWR boasts a full-length MIL-STD 1913 rail, offering the ability to attach various optics. When it comes to weight and dimensions, the XM7 NGSWR, including the suppressor, weighs 9.83 pounds, and without the suppressor, it comes down to 8.38 pounds. The weapon uses a 20-round box magazine crafted from a lightweight polymer material, featuring an angled design for improved ergonomics and a more compact overall length of the rifle. The total length of the XM7 NGSWR, including the suppressor, measures 36 inches, with a barrel length of 13 inches. Equipped with the XM157 next generation fire control system and the SIG SLX suppressor, the XM7 NGSWR becomes even more lethal. Is a rugged fire control system that enhances accuracy and lethality for the close combat force. It integrates multiple advanced technologies such as a variable magnification optic, a backup etched reticle, a laser rangefinder, a ballistic calculator, an astropheric sensor suite, a compass, intra-soldier wireless, visible and infrared aiming lasers, and a digital display overlay. In summary, the XM7 is poised to redefine the standards of combat weaponry. With its transformative features and advanced technology, this assault rifle has the potential to significantly elevate the performance of the US military on the battlefield. Will the XM7 live up to its expectations? Will it successfully replace the long-standing M4 and M16 platforms? Only time and the battlefield will tell. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the M4 and XM7 battle rifle. So, what do you think about these weapons? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you are lucky enough to operate one of the weapons mentioned in this video, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.